Hello everyone, welcome you back in my geography class. Today we will continue with the chapter of the coastal plains and islands of class 4 of social science. In our last video, we have discussed about the life in the western coastal plains in the state of Kerala and the union territory of the Lakshadweep Islands. In this video, we are going to discuss about the life in the eastern coastal plains in the states of Odisha, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, and the union territories of Andaman and Nicobar Islands and Puducherry. So let us start to know about each of the states and union territories, where we will get to know the location, we will get to know about their capital, about the important cities, about the important ports, about the economic activities, the festivals that are celebrated, language, traditional dress, and places of tourist attraction. So let us start with the state of Odisha. The state of Odisha. As we move along the coast towards the south, from West Bengal, we come to Odisha, which was formerly known as Orissa. It is located in the northeastern part of the country. The capital of Odisha is Bhubaneshwar, which is an important city. Other important cities of Odisha are Puri and Cuttack. The delta formed by the Mahanadi River is very fertile. Agriculture is an important economic activity of the people living here in Odisha. The main crop that is grown here is rice. Other important crops that are also grown here are pulses, oil seeds, jute, sugarcane, and coconut. Handloom saris of Odisha and jewelry and decorative items made of silver are very popular. Mining is another important industry of Odisha. Now let us know about the language. Odia is the main language that is spoken here. Bengali is the other language that is spoken by most of the people of Odisha. Now, let's talk about the traditional dress. Women normally prefer to wear the Sambalpuri sari or the Kotoki sari or salwar kameez. Men traditionally wear dhoti, kurta and gamucha. Odissi is the popular dance form of Odisha. Lots of people turn up to see the Rath Yatra of Puri, which is an important festival that is celebrated in Odisha. The temples at Bhubaneshwar, Puri, Konark and the Chilika Lake with its bird sanctuary are the other tourist attractions of Odisha. Now let us do a quick recapitulation what we have learned about Odisha. As we move along the coast towards the south from West Bengal, we come to the state of Odisha. The capital of Odisha is Bhubaneshwar. Puri and Cuttack are important cities of Odisha along with Bhubaneshwar. The delta formed by the Mahanadi River is very fertile. So agriculture is the main economic activity and the main crop that is grown here is rice. Handloom saris and jewelry and decorative items made of silver are very popular. And mining is another important economic activity of the people living in Odisha. The main language that is spoken here is Odia. Coming to the dress, women prefer to wear Sambalpuri or the Kotoki sari, where men wear dhoti, kurta and a gamocha. Odissi is a famous dance form of Odisha. Lots of people turn up to see the Rath Yatra, which is the most important festival that is celebrated here. There are many places which attracts a large number of tourists every year, and some of them are the temples at Puri and Konark. Now let us move ahead with the next state, that is the state of Andhra Pradesh.
The state of Andhra Pradesh. Andhra Pradesh is located in the southeastern part of India. To the northeast of Karnataka is the state of Andhra Pradesh. The capital of Andhra Pradesh is Amravati. Important cities of Andhra Pradesh are Visakhapatnam and Vijayawada. Visakhapatnam, a city on coast, is a major port and shipbuilding center. Agriculture is an important economic activity of the people living in Andhra Pradesh. The rivers Krishna and Godavari forms deltas. Their fertile deltas are ideal for the cultivation of rice. Thus, this region is known as the rice bowl of India. Andhra Pradesh is the largest producer of tobacco. Mining is another important industry of Andhra Pradesh. It has an oil refinery and an iron and steel plant. Fishing is another important economic activity here. Now let us talk about the language. Telugu is the official and most widely spoken language. Other languages which are spoken here are Urdu, Hindi, Tamil, Kannada, Marathi and Uriya. The traditional dress of men of Andhra Pradesh are dhoti and kurta, and women traditionally wear sari and blouse. Important festivals that are celebrated here are Dashera and Eid. Kuchipuri is a famous dance form of Andhra Pradesh. There are many places which attracts a large number of tourists every year to Andhra Pradesh. Some of them are the Velam Caves, Vizag, Talakona Waterfalls, Araku Valley, and the most important is the Venkateshwar Temple in Tirupati, which is visited by lakhs of devotees every year.
Now again it's time for a recapitulation. Let us know what we have learned about the state of Andhra Pradesh. Andhra Pradesh is located in the southeastern part of India. The capital of Andhra Pradesh is Amravati. Visakhapatnam and Vijayawada are the two important cities of Andhra Pradesh. Visakhapatnam is a major port and a shipbuilding center. The rivers Krishna and Godavari forms delta. Thus, agriculture is one of the main economic activity here. This region is known as the rice bowl of India. Andhra Pradesh is also the largest producer of tobacco. Mining is another important economic activity of Andhra Pradesh. Now, coming to the language, Telugu is the official and most widely spoken language. Coming to the dress, men wear dhoti and kurta, whereas women wear sari and blouse. Kuchipuri is a traditional dance form of Andhra Pradesh. Festivals which are celebrated here are Dashera and Eid. The Venkateshwar Temple in Tirupati is a great tourist attraction. And let me tell you, it is the most important tourist attraction because every year lakhs of devotees visit the Venkateshwar Temple in Tirupati. Now let us move ahead with the next state, that is the state of Tamil Nadu.
Tamil Nadu is located in the extreme south of the subcontinent. The capital of Tamil Nadu is Chennai, which is an important city of Tamil Nadu. It lies on the Coromandel coast and is an important port. The Mariana Beach in the city of Chennai is the longest beach in India. Other important cities of Tamil Nadu are Coimbatore, Madurai and Tiruchirappalli. The delta formed by the Kaveri River is very fertile. Agriculture is the main economic activity of the people here. Main crops which are grown here are rice, millet, cereals, pulses and sugarcane. The delta formed by the Kaveri River is very fertile. It is called the rice bowl of Tamil Nadu. Other industries which are well developed here are textile industries, handloom industries and heavy engineering industries. Chennai is an important software development center. Kanyakumari in Tamil Nadu is the southernmost tip of the Indian mainland. Now let us talk about the language. Tamil is the official language and is spoken by most of the people. Other languages which are spoken here are Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam and English. Traditionally, men wear dhoti or lungi and shirt, and women mostly wear saris. The silk saris of Kanchipuram are very famous. The traditional dress for small girls is pavadai blouse. Slightly older girls wear half saris. The main festival that is celebrated here is Pongal. Bharatanatyam is the most famous dance form of Tamil Nadu. There are many places which attracts a large number of tourists every year, and some of them are Kanyakumari, which is the southernmost tip of the Indian mainland, the Vivekananda Rock Memorial, which has been built on a small island near the coast called Vivekananda Rock, Ooty, Chennai, Kanchipuram, Madurai and Thanjavur.
Now let us recapitulate what we have learned about Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu is located in the extreme south of the subcontinent. Chennai, the capital of Tamil Nadu, lies on the Coromandel coast. It is an important port. The Marina Beach in the city is the longest beach in India. The delta formed by the Kaveri River is very fertile. Main crops that are grown are rice, pulses, sugarcane and cotton. It is called the rice bowl of Tamil Nadu. Now talking about the industries, important industries are heavy engineering, textiles and handloom. Kanyakumari in Tamil Nadu is the southernmost tip of the Indian mainland. Now talking about the language, Tamil is the official language spoken by the people of Tamil Nadu. Men wear dhoti or lungi and shirt, and women wear saris. Traditional dress of small girls is pavadai blouse, and slightly older girls wear half saris. The main festival which is celebrated here is Pongal. There are many places which attracts a large number of tourists every year, and some of them are the Vivekananda Rock Memorial, Ooty and Chennai. Now let us move ahead with the union territory of the Andaman and the Nicobar Islands.
Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Andaman and Nicobar Islands form a union territory of India. These are two groups of about 300 islands in the Bay of Bengal. The northern islands are known as the Andaman Islands, which includes North, Middle and South Andaman, which is known as the Great Andaman. The southern islands are known as the Nicobar Islands, which consist 19 islands. Little Andaman in the south is separated from the Nicobar Islands. The capital of Andaman and Nicobar Islands is Port Blair. Only a few of the islands are inhabited. Many of these people live in the forest, in groups or tribes. Some of them are the Sentalese tribe, the Jarwas and the Ongi tribe. Agriculture is the main occupation of most of the residents of the Andaman Islands. Coconut and rice are the main agricultural products. Rubber and cashew also are important. Fishing is another important activity of the people of Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Now let us talk about the languages. Most of the people speak Bengali and Hindi. However, Tamil, Telugu and Malayalam are also common in Andaman and Nicobar Islands. The inhabitants of the Andaman Islands have Andamanese, which is a small group that speak Andamanese language. In Nicobar Islands, the inhabitants speak the Nicobarish language. Now, let us talk about the traditional attire. Different tribes have different tribal attire, like the Jarwas, which are the most dominant tribal group in the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. They dress themselves in necklaces made out of shells and barks of trees and armbands. Here, the main festivals that are celebrated are Kali Puja, Island Tourism Festival, Durga Puja and Deepavali. Tourism is an important industry because of the beautiful beaches. The cellular jail at Port Blair was once used to imprison Indian freedom fighters by the British. It is now a national monument which attracts a large number of tourists every year. Some of the other important places of tourist attractions are the Havelock Island, Neil Island, Ross Island, North Bay Island, Viper Island, Ross and Smith Island, and Barren Island, which is the only active volcano in India.
Now let us recapitulate what we have learned about the Union Territory of Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Andaman and Nicobar Islands are two groups of about 300 islands in the Bay of Bengal. The northern islands are called the Andaman Islands and the southern islands are called the Nicobar Islands. The capital of Andaman and Nicobar Islands is Port Blair. In Andaman and Nicobar Islands, only few of the islands are inhabited by the people. Many of these people live in the forest in groups or tribes. The important economic activities are agriculture, tourism and fishing. Coconut and rice are the main crops that are grown here. Languages which are spoken here are Bengali and Hindi. The inhabitants of the Andaman Islands have Andamanese who speak Andamanese language, and in the Nicobar Islands, the inhabitants speak Nicobarish language. Jarwas, who are the most dominant tribal groups living here, they wear necklaces made of shells, barks of trees and armbands. Others, like the Hindus, the Christians and the Sikhs, the men and women, traditionally they wear sari, salwar, dhoti and so on. Island tourism festival, Kali Puja, Durga Puja and Deepavali are the main festivals that are celebrated here. The most famous place which attracts a large number of tourists every year is the cellular jail at Port Blair, which was once used to imprison Indian freedom fighters by the British and it is now a national monument. Now let us move ahead with the Union Territory of Puducherry.
Puducherry. As we go south from Chennai, along the coast, we come to the Union Territory of Puducherry. It was formerly known as Pondicherry. Agriculture is an important activity of the people living here in Puducherry. Major crops which are grown are rice, sugarcane, cotton and peanuts. Main industries of Puducherry are food processing industry, manufacturing of electrical appliances, textile industry, paper industry and lumber industry. Now let us talk about the languages. The people of Puducherry speak Tamil, English, Telugu and Malayalam. At one time, Puducherry was ruled by the French and that is why some of the people also speak in French language. Men traditionally wear dhoti, kurta or a shirt, but nowadays they can be seen in pants and shirts, whereas women wear sari with blouse and long skirts. Now let us talk about the festivals that are celebrated here. Main festivals of Puducherry are Pongal, Masi Magam festival, birth anniversary of Sri Aurobindo, French food festival and the Vinayaka Chaturthi. There are many places of tourist attraction and some of them are Sri Aurobindo Ashram, Paradise Beach, Auroville, Serenity Beach, the Basilica of the Sacred Heart of Jesus, the Puducherry Botanical Garden and the Old Lighthouse.
Now let us recapitulate what we have learned about the Union Territory of Puducherry. As we go south from Chennai, along the coast we come to the Union Territory of Puducherry. The capital of Puducherry is Puducherry. Agriculture is the main activity and the major crops that are grown here are rice, sugarcane, cotton and peanuts. Important industries are food processing, textile, paper, manufacturing of electrical appliances. Now talking about the language, Tamil, English, Telugu and Malayalam are the common languages that are spoken by the people of Puducherry. Some of them also speak French, as at one time it was ruled by the French. Men wear dhoti, kurta or shirt, and nowadays they also wear pants and shirt. Women wear blouse and long skirts. Festivals which are celebrated here are Pongal and birth anniversary of Sri Aurobindo, which are the two most important festivals celebrated here. Puducherry attracts a large number of tourists every year, but the most famous place of Puducherry is the Aurobindo Ashram. I hope all of you understood what we have discussed in today's video. In today's video, we have discussed about the life in the eastern coastal plains in the states of Odisha, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, and the union territories of the Andaman and Nicobar Islands and Puducherry. Here we got to know about their location, about their capital, about the economic activity, the language, the dress, the festivals that are celebrated, and the places of tourist attraction. If you have any problem, just let me know by a comment in the comment box given below. You can also take the help of the PDF that has been attached in the description box for better understanding of the chapter. If you like my video, don't forget to hit the like button so that I can understand that how much you people are enjoying watching the videos. Do share the video with your friends and don't forget to subscribe my channel to watch more videos on different topics. Stay tuned, I will be back soon with a new chapter. Till then, take care and stay safe. Thank you.